Hello, my beloved brothers and sisters. How are you all doing? We are here on the 4th of May. Tomorrow it's day off in the Netherlands. It's celebration day. It's celebrate our freedom. But what is freedom in a lockdown, right? I'm here and everything is going its way. Everything is moving forward. The energies are high. We've gone through some portals. We had the Schumann resonance going sky high. That means sleepless nights and waking up and doing the work and know it's where it's coming from. The moon moved through Saturnus, so endings for a lot of things, and moved into Jupiter and vice versa. And that means endings and new beginnings, endings of old situations, ending of old relationship and new ones starting to come in. New energies of prosperity, everything will go in flow. If you're on the right path and if you're in the right environment, everything will go in flow and everything will come towards you as you deserve. So let's see.
Ik heb
what's
helaas
so...
geen overeenkomstige surfwinkels kunnen.
Let's go and see. Siri. Let's go and see what the divine masculine is in his headspace. Will teachings, the depth of experience and healing. He's a teacher and a mentor, and he shares his wisdom. So he shares his wisdom with everybody who wants to hear it. It could be that there is another form of wisdom coming to or through him or to him, another way of teaching. And I have a feeling that these teachings that he is going to do are unconscious for many other people, and they will receive it as a gift. It will be received as a gift. So he is diving deep in the waters of his own experience of healing. So it could be that he is sharing his knowledge to heal humanity. And it could be that it's going to be face to face, or via Zoom, or via internet, or through songs. He is going to express his knowledge and his wisdom through multiple teachings. What is in his heart space? In his heart space, there's a resolution. Resolution of old time collapsing. He feels that old times are collapsing, that he's entering a new paradigm, that he has the insights and the higher self embodiment, that his higher self gets more and more embodied. And he feels that energy. He feels that energy of his higher self. So he is more in contact with his higher self. So he can express his emotions in a much better way, and it will be more stabilized. It's in a triangle, it's connected with source. The youthful energy of the dolphins are coming through and is giving him playfulness. He's being watched by the divine feminine, or the goddess, or the universe, as you want to see it. If you want to give it a name or an identity, take your own identity where you resonate most with, and all the insights will come out into expression in his higher self. And that means that he creates a kind of freedom for himself, connected with the earth and connected with the universe. How does he sees the divine feminine? That she is at her sacred mountain, that she is taking time for herself, that she is on a vision quest. Need clarity and truth for herself and seeing the truth, going through the Shambhala healing and going into deep healing for herself. And that's what he sees. He sees she's taking her time to upgrade, upload, and taking good care of herself so that she can be there for everyone else if it's needed. But she is walking her sacred journey and she is going to her sacred mountain and he is seeing that. He knows that she will get the clarity and the truth about everything. So he knows that she is on a vision quest. So what is in the mind space of the Divine Feminine? Her cosmic self. Her cosmic self, and she knows that she is a cosmic being. She's staying confident in her truth, in everything what she sees, in everything what she knows, in everything that what she discovered. She's seeing the truth. Her eyes are open. Her third eyes are open. She is direct connected with the cosmos energy. And getting her knowledge out of the cosmos, her truth out of the cosmic will be shown to her what needs to be done to transform in the other realm or in the third dimensional realm. She is moving beyond any barriers and any restrictions what the normal world, the illusional world is putting up, and she is moving beyond this. So she is embodying her cosmic self, what's in her heart space. She sees the bigger picture and she forgives everyone who does her wrong and who did her wrong. As she knows that it was necessary for her to heal from situations that doesn't resonate with her. So it's now she's on a journey of forgiveness of herself, forgiveness that she was ignorant and didn't want to listen to the environment or the voices that said to her, you're in a wrong there, you're going in a wrong direction. She forgives herself for that because she sees the big picture now and she is trusting it and she is healing from it. So that's what's in her heart space. So if you're in connection with the Divine Feminine and you did her wrong, or anybody else in another realm did her wrong, know that you are forgiven and that she is okay with what happened because she got a bigger insight of it. She got a bigger insight of her shadows that she could transform at another dimension. So her healing kicked in and she was aware of it that she did wrong. And she is forgiven for that, or he is forgiven for that. It's just the way how it resonates with you. What does she see in the Divine Masculine? That he is his cosmic heart source. She is seeing his heart source. She sees the source of all, the truth, the truth, what is in his heart space, what his soul is, who he is as a light being. And he can just be. And she's seeing his heart connection. She's seeing the goodness from his heart. It could be that he is going more to his heart space than he's ever been, and trying to release the ego space, because that's what the divine feminine does. When he sees the divine feminine, his heart is jumping of joy, because she sees him how he is. She sees his true nature, his true light. And when he's around her, he starts to feel comfortable, joyful, nurturing, feeling held, held by the light, held by the source, and they're connecting on a much deeper level than just the ego mind. It's they're connecting on all levels. That's what I see. And that's how she sees the divine masculine. She sees his light. And she also sees when she's around him that he is lighting up, you know, his eyes are lighting up. There's healing, there's love, there is connection. Okay? What is supporting the divine masculine? The tree of life, the circle of life, clear energies, and a clear channel. When he's connecting with the earth, when he's connecting with everything around him, that will, with the earth, the trees, everything else, that is how he is connected, and that will support him. It will give him clarity, more space, more rejuvenation. Connected with the earth grid, and that will activate his body and get more peace. So that will really enjoy him. That will really support him to be more in nature, to be more with the trees, connecting with the trees. Yeah. Well, how does he see the divine feminine? She's awakening. She knows who she is, and he knows who she is. And he sees that she gets DNA activations, and that means that she is coming original in her true, authentic energy of love in the heart space. There is no harshness, there is no ego, it's just the heart and the love space. And he is happy for her that she is in that state of awakening, that she is in that surroundings, that she can be her authentic self, and that she is awakening to all new things that are coming her way. From higher dimensions, higher frequencies, and that she's all in alignment with it. She knows, he knows that she receives DNA activations from rituals, from doing her work. It could be that she's breaking some energies, breaking some old energies that she was connected with. And that now she is going in that flow of release, you know, she released so much, and now it's the connection. She knows this, there is this connection with Egypt that is flowing through her chakras and grounding it into the earth of and the surroundings of the pyramids, that she is going to multiple dimensions, that she is going to astral travel wherever she wants to go. And that's what he's seeing. He's seeing her start to glow, start to activate, start to shine. that her chakras are open, that she is connected, and that's how he sees her in the relationship. He knows when she is in this divine connection and in this divine relationship with Source, that it will fulfill her, and that it is her journey and her destiny. And he loves that about her. For the divine feminine, what will support her? She is going through the fire of transformation. She's going through radical purification, releasing. She is throwing everything in the violet flame for transmuting all the energies. She's surrendering to what is, and she knows there will be a resurrection. She will not take any risks, not any chances. She knows that she is recuperating, that she has to fill up her cup, and that is what she will do. She will rejuvenate herself. It could be that she is like the phoenix burned down to the ashes to rise above it totally. She knows that there is another purpose for her, and that the universe is showing her where to go and where to put the focus on. So there wouldn't be a burden from the past, that there wouldn't be a burden of lack of hurt, of commitment, or carrying the burdens of someone else. She shook this off her back, and she released it in the fire. Her heart is on fire. Her heart is burning, because she knows that when the sun is in her heart space, everything will be okay. You know, when she's connecting with the true authentic self and the cosmic self, that she has nothing to fear, and that everything will work for her best interest. That everything will come her way has a meaning, or to transform, or to come out as a better version of herself. How does she see the relationship with the divine masculine? She knows that that there is a star connection, that there is a guidance from the star that brings them together, the galactic self and the in the unified field. So they know each other from a different stargates, different planets, and they know each other from different lifetimes. That always will be that soul connection, and it doesn't matter from which realm that is. If it's from the Nordic realm, is it's from the ancestors, is it, if it's from the Indians, if it's from the ancestors of Central America or South America. She knows that there were many, many multiple lives that they were connected, and that they are now in a space that they see each other again, but they see each other for who they are, you know, where they are in this space at this moment. And it could be that they are in the space of in the Viking energy, or in the South American energy. And they are seeing who they are at this moment. So it's okay. You don't have to be in my realm if I already been in that realm. Or I don't have to be in your realm because I've been in your realm. So that's what is happening, because they know that everything is cosmic arranged, and that there is this star connection. It doesn't matter if there's a star connection with Egypt or other countries. they know that their hearts are connected towards each other, and that's heart opening. As they see their light, if they see their cosmic selves, if they see their earthly bodies for who they are. Okay, let's get a card for the Divine Masculine. And a card for the Divine Feminine. Oops, a bit too much. For all my brothers and sisters, I still want to wish you a very happy Beltane as the Beltane season is started. The unity of the Divine Masculine and Feminine. It will happen in this cluster. One overall cards. Card for the Divine Masculine. One card for the Divine Feminine. Whoops, everything is flying. A lot of energies here. Overall cards. Okay, and let's get the star cards. One card for the Divine Feminine. One card for the overall energy. Okay, let's see what's going on. For the overall card is loosen your grip. Coping mechanism, destiny, attraction, let God in. It could be that there is a not an attraction, but an addiction. It could be that there's an addiction of holding on to the past, that there is an addiction of coping mechanisms, that you, you know, not reacting as you should, if your soul wants to connect with someone, and you feel that it is an connection or a habit out of addiction, you know, you need to have let God in and loosen your grip. So destiny can do its work. So destiny can come in, and divine timing. And that's for the masculine and the feminine both. There is for both, there is healing. Imagine yourself and your beloved surrounded by light. Feel your relationship being healed at this very moment. And then there is healing coming in. Then there is healing coming in. Let each other go. Give each other space. Give each other freedom. Joy. Have joy in your life. Playful thinking, playful communication, singing, dancing, and do the things what makes you happy for both of them. Let's see for the Divine Masculine. Inward revolution. It could be that he got pushed to do some work that could be revolutionary. You know, there's an inward change going on. And in this change, it needs to be revolutionary. It could be ideas. It could be a new a new birth of a project that will come his way, and that he has to sit on it and let it work out. So so the resolutions. What is not coming from the outside, but is coming from the inside. So it could be that in combination with healing, it could also mean that the Divine Masculine is healing through inward revolution, and that he is standing up for himself in light. You know, that he sees that he needs to be healed, that he needs to have time on his own and do some things that really activates him. Life is a series of constantly shifting cycles. When we resist the change, we resist the natural flow of life. And we create unnecessary stress. Go with the flow and you will be surprised where it leads you. So let it all go and accept the shifting cycles. Don't resist the change. Go in that natural flow of life. And don't create unnecessary stress. Go with that flow. You will be surprised where it's leading you. Because if you resist the change, nobody will benefit from it, because there are lessons to learn, and the lessons are to learn for the Divine Masculine and the Divine Feminine also, because they're both on a healing journey. And that healing journey will bring them back together into a heart space of love. And they see each other with love. They don't see any obstacles with each other. They see just the progress and the solution of things, but also new possibilities, because they differ from each other. And when if you recognize the difference in each other, it's and you accept it, it's also possible to come closer towards each other and understand each other. For the Divine Masculine, he is cold. He is called to a new training. His soul got a gift. And the gift of the Divine Masculine is a training, and it's time to step up. It's time to step up for himself, where he had procrastination. He feels now new things are coming around, and he needs to fulfill that gift, because it's a gift. He needs to fulfill that. He needs to go through the portal, and if there is a new project for him or a new love that he wants to go after, he is called to go and go through that door and get his divine feminine, because there is no difference between the masculine and the feminine at the moment, because they're both in balance. They both know each other from different worlds, from different energies, and they don't have any judgment on each other. And that's why he wants to go through that portal and get his divine feminine. Okay, let's see what's going on with the divine feminine. Wellness. She needs to take care of herself, of her wellness of being, of her meditation, take more rest, needs to withdraw, needs to connect with everything around her. Could be that she is connecting with the earth, with the elements, and with the goddesses, or with the realm, or the cosmic realm. And that's what she will receive, to feel herself in a place of wellness. Could be that she needs a massage. Could mean that she needs to take care of herself, and that is what she wants to, what she's going to do. Okay, you may not always understand why certain things happen. However, there's always a higher purpose to the events in your life. Through turmoil, a blessing will soon be revealed. So it could be that you don't understand why things happen in your life. Even if it's bad, you know, it's always for the good of you. So you will understand things, so things have a higher purpose for you, to let you understand that when there is this higher purpose coming through you, then you will find out that everything goes in flow. That is no procrastination in your life, that things needed to be, that they are to be, that that you always receive a blessing out of this, because it could be that there is a lesson to be learned that you didn't see in the beginning. You know, it could be that your counterpart learned from his lesson. It could be that he is growing up, that he's getting the courage to step forward towards his divine feminine. Because maybe he was doubting in the first place, and now he's seeing she's working her ass off, and he will take the step towards her. Okay. For the divine feminine, empathic starseed, energetic sovereignty, absorbing what's not yours. So this empathic starseed needs to know that there are energies around her that are not hers, but that she is absorbing it as her own. So it could be when she is interacting with other energies, her behavior starts to change. And she needs to be in that energetic sovereignty of her own, you know, her own sovereignty, her own thing, her own protection of this. And it's very hard for the divine feminine if you're a starseed empathic person and you go in a third dimensional realm, in a lower frequency, that you are carrying all the energies of that third dimensional realm. And it could be, from the persons you live with. It could be from the energy they take home from work. It could be, and you are transmuting and feeling all of it. You're feeling the collective, you're feeling all of it. And sometimes that's very hard for you to transmute. So you need to go through a next portal. And also through a portal of light to protect yourself from this. Because you know that your light, you're putting your light in a darker environment. When all the dark absorbs the light, it could be that you're getting tired, you're getting in your mind space that you can't be yourself anymore because you can't you're not in connection with that higher frequency of the heart space of the connection of the frequency of where you belong. And it could be as every country has its own vibration, as every country has their own frequency. And when you're living in a portal, like for instance here in Glastonbury, the heart portal, it's almost impossible to live or go somewhere else where the frequency are low and there is reptilian energy all around you. So it will be a struggle for an empath to be in a lower frequency, okay? Because she sees that that world isn't a real world. That world is created for slavery. It's not the world that that was meant for people to be. The world is meant for people to live and do the things from their heart space and not be a slave of the community, of work, of anything else. And government, that's for sure. So when you raise your vibration and getting out of that environment, then it will be an amazing space for you to thrive and to make everything go in flow and make it a realization, and everything will be manifest for you because you're coming from that heart space, you're coming from that higher frequency. And when you're moving down into another environment, it could take up to maybe maximal 3 weeks, and then you're going, then your light is taking off. They're taking away your light, they're taking away your energy, they're living on your energy. And when that happens, the other persons around you starts to manifest, and your light starts to dim. And you need to be aware of that. And if there is not a continuously flow of that frequency, then it's very hard to maintain that. Okay, so that's how the empathic star seeds operate in this world and how it works for them. Okay. Well, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being in my space. I ask you, if you like my readings, there's a donation button. Please hit the button for donations. It's a Dharma energy. It's an exchange energy for my readings. If you want to have a private reading about your divine masculine and where your blocks are in the twin flame relationship, where you need to move towards to, and remove, and if you need a healing to remove all these uncomfortabilities that is within you, when you heal yourself, you will also heal your divine masculine on that same level or on different levels. So if you're interested in a private reading, contact me in the description box below. You will find everything. And I will see you next week. Bye-bye.